Government seeks another $26 billion from Parliament. Ombudsman has no investigators. Amanda is required to pursue degrees. And government spends $53 billion over budget and still needs more. I'm Enrico Pulford, and this is Uncut News. Do you see news happening? Send us a tip on WhatsApp at 592-659-6151. The government has approached the National Assembly for approval of an additional $26 billion in supplementary funding. However, $5.1 billion of the requested funds was already spent from the contingency fund to pay for cash grants for the severed sugar workers, parents of school children, the flood relief fund, and other cash grant initiatives. However, it is only now seeking approval for those monies that it already spent. With the additional $21 billion the government is seeking, it hopes to pay GPLs $4 billion in arrears, which I don't know who they owe, another $7.7 billion for the Ministry of Housing, $440 million to finance indigenous projects, $755 million will go to emergency drainage works, $225 million to repair police cars, $150 million for a fire truck at the airport, $140.7 million to repair and build fire hydrants in Georgetown, as well as several different housing schemes, $16.6 million will go to rehabilitation works at City Hall, and billions more are to go to pay for construction at Teddy Jargon. Nevertheless, they are seeking more money 6 months after the House approved a $21 billion supplementary budget, which was in addition to the $383 billion budget which was passed in January of this year. This $26 billion funding request will be debated next week in Parliament. Despite being the department tasked with protecting citizens from government corruption and abuse of power, the Office of the Ombudsman has no investigators. This is a situation that has been ongoing for years, and it is because of a lack of investigators there's been little to no progress done on most cases. Out of some 87 complaints received between 2019 and 2020, only 37 were resolved, and 28 of said cases were actually out of the jurisdiction of the office. Ombudsman retired Justice Winston Patterson said that the police commissioner were among the officials who failed to reply to his correspondence, although multiple reminders were sent. On Monday, Jagdeo led a team that engaged with civil society on the final consultation of the draft local content policy before its tabling in the National Assembly on Thursday. This would be the first reading of the highly anticipated bill that is expected to outline how much the oil industry will be operated by Guyanese companies. And speaking of local content, since Exxon can't wait for us to build another one, their country manager, Alistair Rutledge, announced that they will be establishing their own shore base for the Yellowtail project, despite not even having official government approval for said Yellowtail project. But he said, do not worry about any lost funds, because Exxon and the rest of their subcontractors have actually been relocating their operations to Guyana from Trinidad, so expect more business soon, supposedly. Now it's time to tell you about Best Buy's car of the day. Currently on sale is this 2011 Subaru Forester XT. It comes with all-wheel drive, driving modes, Bluetooth, mug rims, new tires, TV, CD, stereo, reverse camera, rear spoiler, and much more. Buy cash for $4.7 million. All pay down as low as $940,000, down with around $106,500 monthly for 4 years, and it is yours. Call or WhatsApp 662-0844 for more info. Or visit the showrooms at Lot 171 Peter Roshi, Queenstown, or Lot 2 Lama Street, and Alan Mirico sent you for this sweet deal. Do you know what I and the president have in common? Well, aside from both of us having excellent facial hair and a love of square frames, well, we both can't stand dunce cops. We hate them both, honestly. He can't stand it so much that he's making each police commander go to UG, and the government will pay for them to pursue bachelor's and master's degrees. But they are not alone. At least 50 regular police officers and several GDF ranks per year will be nominated for full scholarships to go to UG. So, good for them. The GRA is desperately trying to hold on to the few trained petroleum revenue auditors they have, as a majority of them left for greener pastures in the private sector the second they received their training. Because petroleum auditing is new to Guyana and no foreigner wanted to work for chump change, the GRA decided to train several in-house staff members who were then expected to train others. But instead of doing that, most of them left. The Petroleum Revenue Department has a staff of 26, but with plans to fill the cost audit vacancies, the number is expected to increase to 48 by year end. But they believe that will only be possible if the people are properly compensated for their work, obviously. Granger will miss this weekend's PNC Congress as he's headed to Cuba today for medical reasons. He did not give details of his current medical condition to the party's Central Executive Committee, but he did miss several follow-up visits to his doctors in Cuba because of the Rona travel restrictions. He did not tell the committee when he would return. But I assume he's probably going to move to that farm up the highway Jagdeo said he was going to move to when the PPP lost in 2015. Are you still using a Mongo Pelter by choice? Or you simply can't afford a new cell phone? Good news for you! Digicel is slashing prices in half on the Samsung A3, the DL3 Pro and Pro Plus this Christmas. Upgrade to a brand new smartphone for just $9,750 at any Cellular Plus Digicel store. This offer includes a free one-month Prime Bundle data plan. Pro tip, smartphones make good presents. The Minibus Union has just implemented a uniform policy in an attempt to prevent touting. While the policy has been in place for a while now, they are now trying to get uniforms to all its members. While I'm all for the uniforms, I really don't see how that will eradicate touting. The police are literally right there at the park. And they don't even care to enforce the law, so I fail to see how a collared jersey and a cop would make a difference. Oh well. It's now time for today's Run Report. Today, the nation recorded 50 new cases. There are now 1,024 persons dead, 10 in the ICU, 757 in home isolation. And the total number of confirmed cases around the nation now stands at 38,618. So please, people, wash your hands frequently. Avoid touching your nose and mouth and mask up before you leave the house. When you do leave home, try to avoid enclosed spaces and large crowds, and remember to give 6 meters space between you and others. And now for the vaccines. 406,748, or 79.3% of adults, have had the first dose, and 287,362, or 56, have had both. As for the teens, 29,807, or 40.9% have had the first, and 21,045, or 28.9% are fully vaccinated. You there, Mr. Truckman. Hit all your high-quality truck parts at 5-15% off during the Christmas season. Nice up your truck and get it ready for work in 2022. Visit Powered Automotive Truck Spares and Engine Parts at 1161 EE Eccles. They are the biggest truck parts store in Guyana with a wide variety of parts and exceptional customer service. Call the WhatsApp 697-0171. Now for our stupid news of the day. You know what I think is stupid? Wasteful government spending. Yes, I know I said I would talk about the police bill, but this is more concerning to me. And by this, I mean news that since coming into office, the government spent $53 billion more than it budgeted for, and yet they still need more money. So despite having already received billions in supplementary funds, they are again in Parliament asking for even more money. You know, Winston Churchill allegedly once said, "Never let a good crisis go to waste." And it seems like that is exactly what the past and this present government seem to be doing. But the concerning thing for me is that while APNU wasted millions in taxpayer dollars through sheer incompetence and greed, this present government has elevated wasteful spending to an art form. It is concerning when you consider that over the past year and a half, the government cut millions of dollars in taxes, gave out millions in subsidies and unaudited relief grants, spent millions on overpriced poor quality infrastructure projects, borrowed billions in loans from foreign banks, mainly Chinese, paid Exxon's unaudited local content bill and their income taxes, spent $10 billion additional dollars on the airport after promising not to spend any more. They neglected to assign a new public procurement commission board. They gave out billion-dollar contracts without the PPC's approval, because they didn't exist. They refused to hire auditors and financial investigators. Then, after all of that, they want to demand more money, no questions asked. Now, I'm not accusing them of stealing money, as I'm sure things are way more complex and not so black and white, it's honestly shades of grey. But it begs the question, why are we as citizens satisfied with trusting that you can't trust your government? That is exactly why the public needs to demand greater transparency on how our money is being spent. One way is to have a database of such information on the front page of a government website for all to see. Because when you think about it, hoping your government is doing the right thing without actually holding them accountable is pretty stupid. Moving on to our uncut news, fusible question of the day. Every day we pose a question about current events in Guyana, the region, the diaspora, and how you feel it relates to us. So you give your responses, and we'll read the best ones in the following episode. Yesterday's question was, do you think it's a good idea to change the laws to make it easier for private citizens to legally obtain a gun? Everett Lawrence says, they need Sharia laws in Guyana. That's the only time we're going to have low crime and discipline in regards to life. Oh my, so not even guns, but Sharia will deal with it. Oh, my. So, before we get to tonight's question, you can move into your very own luxury home in 2022. Lenora Estates West Coast MRR Properties could have you saying goodbye to a landlord in no time. Call or WhatsApp 592-618-5702 and ask about in-house financing. So, for tonight's question, how do you feel about the billions the government is requesting in supplementary funding? Should it be approved, or should it be scrutinized more? Why or why not? Think about that question and tell us in the comments below. If your response is good enough, we just might feature it in our next episode. Anyway, that's all the time we have for tonight, and check us out tomorrow for another. Until then, I'm Rico Bullford saying good night, folks.
Hey, Uncut News viewers, thanks for watching. You can subscribe by clicking on this button over here, or click over there for more news. You can also drop a comment to let me know if you've made it to the end of the video. Goodbye for now!